Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now, as promised in the previous part, in this part we are going to tackle the final castle of level 5, yeah, that's right. We cleared out the small towers last time, picked up our big shield. In the meantime, I went to a shop and upgraded my armor to the final level, so we are now wearing full plate. Unfortunately, I haven't had a chance to get any experience with it yet, so it's at the moment still a little bit weaker than our old half plate was, but that will change very quickly. What I also did is I went to the king to get two more level ups, which I used to invest a little bit in magic resistance, but mostly in wisdom this time. I picked up two extra levels in wisdom, as you can see, at the advice of one of our viewers, actually. Basically to make our items a little bit more operable, which is something you really do want to do later on in the game. Early in the game, things like red potions and stuff, they're not very important. It's pretty cheap to go to the healer anyway. But at this stage, it's definitely worth it to be able to use three or so potions to get to full health. Also because we have quite a lot of them by now, I'm expecting. Let me have a quick look here. Yeah, see, we have 40 red potions, so it'd be nice to be able to use some of those. These snowmen, I always kind of ignore them because they don't drop anything good anyway. And I'm gonna need, I can use them later to get back up to this portal to go back to level 4. Because if we kill all the monsters down here, there's no way to get out. The only way would be to use a winged boot to fly up to this thing or something, but yeah, that's a little bit expensive. I'll show you how it works in a bit, by the way. I don't think I've shown those before. In fact, I think I'll make another item video soon because, yeah, there's a lot of items we've picked up in the meantime that I haven't really showed you yet. For now, let's clear out the final castle in level 5. Oh, these are poison guys, so you don't want to open this box. We do want to get the gold. We'll immediately pick up these Maddox as well, which is very nice. Now in this tower you'll be able to see why I recommend picking up so many keys. Already you're seeing that these rooms are, well, not all of them, but many of them are locked on all sides. Okay, these are food guys, so we can just magic them away. In fact, I think I'll leave a couple alive for the moment. We'll get the rest of them on the way out. These are the evasion type monsters anyway. Now let me see, I mapped out a route I wanted to take. Yeah, let's go this way first. Oops, snowmen. I hate snowmen. Because they are strong and they don't give us anything worthwhile. In this case, I think a lamp or something. Spectacle. We do want to let ourselves get hit a couple of times. Oh yeah, a lamp. In this tower, just to get our experience with our armor up a little bit. As you saw before, our defense is down to under 5,000, which is kind of bad. By the end of the tower, hopefully we'll be closer to, say, maybe 10,000 or so, which will help us in the next level. These are the gold variety stirropers, so we can magic them away. Very nice amounts of golds from these guys, so we do lose a lot of keys in this tower, but the amount of gold we pick up will take care of that, probably. Although, unfortunately, due to our high level, keys are now, I think, 1,000 gold each, so yeah, they're getting pretty expensive. Yeah, let's just get hurt a little bit, that's okay. Again, pick up some more experience, increase our defense a bit. We will need it for the following levels. Okay, now this is a good room to show you one of the items we haven't used before. And oh yeah, these guys drop a key, so we do want to kill these with the melee weapon as well. Any key is going to be valuable from here on. Okay, so if any monsters drop keys, then definitely try and grab those from them. Of course, we can still kill the rest with our normal attacks, magic attacks. Hey, That's a little bit painful. Okay, so now we have this room, which I happen to know. We kind of want to clear out all four directions. So, instead of wasting a lot of gold on four keys, what we do is we equip our pendant, where is it? There, number L, and use it. Now, clearly this is more cost effective than using four separate keys. First we'll go down south, some more Staropers. There's a bunch of gold variety Staropers in this tower, so these guys mean that the cost for opening these doors will be covered. Oh, if you've been paying attention, by the way, my wizard experience now outstrips my fighter experience. Just from this one or two levels that we used mostly magic to clear, our wizard experience has skyrocketed. Oops. Oh well. And these guys, are these important? Not really, I could have just magicked these. This room is kind of a wash. You pick up a key, you use it again immediately, so we could have probably skipped this one. Actually, it might have been better because we used the key to get in as well. But, oh well. You can't play 100% optimally all the time. Now, this room is different. This one is clearly dangerous and empty, and it's going to cost us a key to get back out. But these are the Madoc type Myconids. So a Madoc is definitely worth two keys. Accidentally shot a chest there, but that's okay. And of course these are Myconids, so we'll also take a fairly big chunk of damage, but again a Madoc is going to be worth it. Now we are pretty badly damaged, so let me just show you with our new wisdom what a red potion does. We are at 60,000 roughly, so we heal 20,000 hit points with a single red potion, and that's the first time I've used one in the entire game, so our experience is still very low with them. As we experience up and as we increase our wisdom a little bit, we'll easily be able to heal 50 or 60,000 hit points in a single potion, so yeah, later on they are definitely worthwhile. Okay, let's keep going. This is going to be a two-part video, by the way, because there's no way I'm going to be able to finish this entire tower in one go. Let me check real quick. Oh yeah, this is, yep. We're going to continue straight up from here. Oops. Oh well, we're going to have to open that later anyway. I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Oops, that was a kind of a mistake. These are food guys, so you might as well just shoot them. On the other hand, it's never a bad idea to try and use your fighter skills, even if they do you a little bit of damage, because of course you want to get your fighter experience up a little bit as well. Again, these are gold, I think. Now you can see we've got another kind of special item in this room, and that is a purple Bible. Like the other special items, this one increases your statistics, and might not be surprising to you to learn that a Bible will increase our wisdom. So we're at 35 now, and now we're at 45. This tower has a couple more of these kinds of items, so yeah, definitely try and find them all. I think these guys are pendant, are they? Yeah, so we are going to take some time to clear out these guys. Pendants are worth up to four keys, so yeah. If one key is worth it, then four is definitely worth it. And some random gold as well. Don't really need that, but whatever. Note that we're back up to 24,000 gold again already. That's how fast gold comes in these later levels. It's just, yeah, in the first few levels you're kind of struggling, and as soon as you get to level 5, gold is never really going to be an issue again. It's more important to keep an eye on your food and make sure you're well stocked than it is to be very careful with your gold. Wait, what was this again? Oh yeah, key. The reason I know all this stuff is because I always map out these places before I go in, at least from level 5 onward, because there is no way you could efficiently and effectively get through these towers just by wandering around. Yeah, you lose so much food and so many keys that way that it's just not effective. Oh, okay. Damn, I almost shot that key. Kill these guys. Oh, you know what? I probably should have used my melee weapon on these guys because they are basically free experience. Oops. Oh. Like I was saying before, our wizard experience at the start of this tower was pretty close to our fighter experience. But you'll see that even after these few rooms, I mean, we're not even halfway yet, our wizard experience is already way outstripping our fighter experience. It's just going to go very quickly from here on. So we'll definitely probably end up being higher level wizard than fighter. Oops. Are these poison? No, these are Madoc, so I do want to kill these with my regular attack. Yep. Here's another one of these special items I was talking about, the purple boots, and they, you might think either dexterity or agility. Agility might make a little bit more sense because they're boots, not gloves, but in fact they increase our dexterity by 10. Not the most important stuff to collect, but still worth it. Oops. Shot another box. And another one. Now that is unlucky because I think, yeah, these are the gold ones. Damn. I should have been a little bit more careful with this one. But oh well. Not the biggest problem. Like I said, we're swimming in gold now anyway, so. Another black onyx. I'll showcase the black onyx a little bit more later too. I have a little bit of an idea for a sort of bonus episode. And now we are getting the very nice items. Another mushroom. We've seen this one before. What was it? Level 3? Level 4? Level 3, I think. But I'll show you again. Our maximum hit points right now is 146,000. After we collect it, it's 161,000, so yeah, definitely a big improvement. Okay guys, that's all the time for this video. I'll continue this in the next one. See you there.